now look at the various properties of alkaline earth metals. The table you just saw displays some of the interesting properties of the elements in the periodic table. There are mainly four properties of alkaline earth metals. 1. The atomic size or the atomic radius. 2. Ionization energy. 3. Electronegativity. 4. Melting and boiling point. Let's move ahead and know more about these properties of alkaline earth metals. We just saw that the atomic number increases as we move down in the periodic table. With the increasing atomic number and electronic configuration, it becomes obvious that the atomic size also increases from beryllium to radium. The atomic size is actually the atomic radius measured in angstroms. What is the reason for this trend? Just think for a few seconds. Well, okay. Let me explain it to you in detail. If you notice the table again, observe that as you move down from beryllium to radium, the principal quantum number of the valence electron increases from 2 to 7 under the electronic configuration column. What does it mean? It means that each successive element has an extra shell as we move down from beryllium to radium. This causes an increase in the size. So remember that the atomic size of the alkaline metals increase as we go down from beryllium to radium. Now let's look at the ionization energy of all these alkaline metals. Before starting this topic, let me ask you a question. What is ionization energy? It is the energy required to remove an electron from an isolated gaseous atom in its ground state. There are actually two levels of ionization energy in each element. First ionization energy and second ionization energy. Ionization energy is measured in kilojoules per mole. Now, if you see the ionization energies of all the alkaline metals, the ionization energy level decreases as you move down from beryllium till radium. Can you think of what is the reason for this trend? Well, why don't you think of the definition and then relate it with the trend in the atomic size? Got it? Don't worry, relax and listen further. As the number of principal shell increases, the attraction of the nucleus on valence electrons decreases. This makes the removal of the outer electrons easy. That's why the ionization energy decreases going down in the group. So you saw how the atomic size and the ionization energies of the alkaline metals behave as you move down the periodic table from beryllium to radium. Now let's move on and find the relationship of the earlier properties with the electronegativity of the alkaline earth metals. What is the trend in electronegativity? Let's see the image of the atom. As you saw that the atomic size increases, the binding attraction of electron with the respective nucleus decreases automatically. Therefore, the ionization energy also decreases. So it becomes easier to remove an electron from the alkaline elements as we move down in the table. The electron at the outer shell has less ionization energy and is easily removable than the other two shells of the atomic structure. Based on the fact that there is a decrease in the ionization energy, the electronegativity level also decreases as we move down from beryllium to radium. Electronegativity of elements is measured in Pauling scales. So, are you finding these properties and their trends interesting? Let us now look into another set of properties of these alkaline earth metals. That is, their boiling points and their melting points. These alkaline metals have higher boiling and melting points. The metallic bonds between atoms in the alkaline metals are stronger than other metals. But you know what? You will not find here any increasing or decreasing trend for the values of the melting and the boiling points. And there is a reason for this too. The irregularly placed melting and boiling points of these alkaline metals are due to the differences in the packaging of atoms in the crystals and the interatomic forces. Now let us revise what we have learned about the properties so far in today's lesson. Atomic numbers and electronic configuration increases, therefore atomic sizes also increase from beryllium till radium. Ionization energy and electronegativity decreases from beryllium till radium. Melting and boiling points of these elements are higher than those of other metals. So you all have understood the various properties of the alkaline earth metals. Now, why don't we discuss the impact of these metals having such unique properties? In this context, it would be interesting to see and understand how these alkaline earth metals react with various other substances. We read that their electronegativity decreases as we move down from beryllium to radium. This would of course mean that they are highly electropositive in nature and therefore they are chemically very reactive. Because of this property, they easily react with various nonmetals to form compounds and hence usually do not reside in a free form state. So shall we now look into some of the reactions of alkaline earth metals to better understand their characteristics?